Doctors are demanding our hospitals get back on a war footing as New South Wales racks up its highest COVID caseload in 50 days. The surge is being blamed on the new stealth Omicron subvariant, and it sparked a renewed plea for everyone to get boosted.
It may be quiet at Sydney's once overrun drive-through COVID clinics, but health officials are bracing for a new surge.
We're going to see a rapid increase in the number of cases.
It's already begun. More than 20,000 new cases were reported yesterday, the state's highest number of daily infections since just before Australia Day. One reason, the super-spreading BA2 subvariant, known as stealth Omicron, already blitzing China and parts of Europe.
BA2 is really important, but also is the opening up of schools and workplaces. So people are mingling, they're crowding, they're mixing.
The good news, there hasn't been an uptick in hospitalisations so far.
There's always a gap of about 2 weeks between a rise in numbers of cases and the number of people who are hospitalised.
Still,
I can tell you absolutely 100% that as Health Minister, I'm not keen to see us heading quickly back towards restrictions.
But doctors want our hospitals back on a war footing. They're also worried about elective surgery being cancelled again.
That after 2 years of playing that game, we've now got a lot of people whose less urgent problems are now more urgent.
The new variant is also wiping out more health staff. As of yesterday, 2,757 were furloughed, either because they've caught the virus or their household contacts. It's 1,000 more than at the same time last month.
Another problem, vax rates. Today, the mass hub at Sydney Olympic Park was dead quiet. Third shots are at just 57%.
My message there is get back for your booster fast, very fast.
In the US, Pfizer is seeking authorisation for fourth shots for over 65s. Our officials could have news on that front too within weeks.
It is more likely than not that they will recommend a second booster or a fourth jab for older Australians, most probably over 65.
Another big number today, 100 million telehealth appointments since the pandemic began.
Barely existed before the pandemic. Now it's permanent. Now it's forever.
Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.